mature enough to read the Bible.
Yeah. Right. I just forgot to push the button.
Whether I'm mature enough to read the Bible and get married and raise children and all that, I know I'm not mature enough to do that. So, in a way, here's what Gandhi said about spirituality. He says, we're all children spiritually. Now, to be a man means to represent what you believe that God means to you. So he was an effective. He said, I am a Christian, I am a Jew, I'm a Muslim, I'm a Hindu, I'm a Sikh. And I'm none of these things. I'm all these things.
That sounds like confusion.
He was doing that to keep the British from dominating the Indian people.
I'm right. What the British did down there, that was wrong.
Right.
Right. But see, I don't, like, to me, Gandhi means nothing.
But you know, he influenced Martin Luther King.
Yeah,
he was
his struggle.
He was a false prophet.
Martin Luther King
when
was.
They were both killed.
Yeah.
No.
False prophet.
You know, there's a lot of people out there to say that Gandhi was actually an agent of the British. He worked for the British intelligence agency.
Right, and Martin Luther King was set up by our government here.
Yeah, well,
he was actually he was part of the Boule Society, a secret society himself.
Yeah,
he was
part of the secret society.
Under what you call, are you familiar with the 501c3?
No.
That's a tax charter that these churches are under for these taxes, so they wanted to pay
tax free. I agree with you guys. I'm against the worldly church.
Good.
Because it dominates. Innocent people are being. They're being weakened by those agents of, maybe, I don't know, I think that when Peter and Paul messed up the original teachings of the Jewish Christians, Peter went to Rome, right? Paul went to all these pagan Greek-speaking cities.
Hold on, before you go forward, what did the Lord say about, well, let me get a scripture. Well, go ahead, say what you're saying.
Which
let
one
me, Matthew 19, where he said, I give you the keys and give the rock, Peter the rock. Go ahead, continue on.
But what I'm saying, James, Jesus' brother,
wanted
everyone to stay coached and be certain.
Peter actually had an argument with Paul.
Okay.
And Paul lost the argument.
Right.
Because Paul said, you did not have to be physically circumcised.
Right.
They had a council. Peter said, yes, you do have to be. So Peter said, yes, you do have to keep that law. And Paul lost that argument.
Okay.
That's in the book of Galatians.
Was it Galatians? I was never mature enough, young enough to do what you guys are doing.
Yeah, I mean,
study the scriptures. Because
you'll have a lot of people out here, like, there's a lot of teachers out here who like to speak ill of Paul, say Paul was not a true follower of the Lord. He perverted the teachings.
Yeah, that's quite controversial.
These are all, you know, that's what we call mischievous madness.
Okay.
You know, because you got a lot of deceivers out here, bro. They're trying to lead our people.
You said 19?
It's either 19 or 18. It might be an 18. I could find it.
I'm just saying that from what I studied, when I was studying this more seriously, James wanted everyone to stay in Jerusalem.
Maybe it's 16.
In Jerusalem and stay good Jews. So when the worldly church was supposed to be representing Jesus, there would be none of
16
this.
17.
None of these divisions.
What scripture is that, though?
Matthew
it's
16,
not in
17.
A scripture. It's
so,
from my understanding of why.
So where did you get this
Jesus
understanding from?
Today,
where did you get this understanding from if it's not in the scripture?
By doing research. It's in the scripture.
What's in the scripture?
As that, well, you know when they had the Council of Nicaea?
Right.
What happened to the Bible? It was codified.
It already was before that.
Okay.
See, even you had the Septuagint, which was, so they already had a canon of the Old Testament before the Lord himself was born.
Okay.
When the Septuagint, which was all the books of the Old Testament, they was already bound together and said, look, these are the books.
Uh-huh.
And then by the time, there's a false teaching out there that teaches, during the Council of Nicaea, that's when Constantine created the Bible and said that these are the proper books of the Bible. But that's not true because there's nowhere to prove. They don't have any documents to prove that.
Right.
That there is. So what happened at the Council of Nicaea was they set doctrine. They set doctrine. Constantine didn't even make Christianity the state religion.
No.
That was Theodosius.
Okay.
That was some years after Constantine. So it wasn't even made the official religion until years after Constantine.
So those people that say he did are lying.
Well, unknowingly.
Yeah, I understand.
I mean, they're not. A lot of them, they think they're telling the truth, but.
Well, the people in the worldly church that told me this, they go, well, Constantine was a Roman emperor, he killed people, he raped people. By the time he's becoming a Christian, how's he going to represent Jesus? Say, well, that's the way it is.
Well, what Constantine did, the Because he stopped the persecution of Christians, of Israelites. He stopped, because before they had laws that, where they actively pursued so-called Christians and killed them, persecuted them. He stopped that. That's what he did. He put an end to it. And then everybody knows he had...
So he's still pagan, bro.
Well, he probably, yeah. So he wasn't totally converted himself as far as...
See, when I met this girl from India, I'm not saying you need to meet a real rabbi or whatever. No, this is how Lucas talking. Yeah. So, what I'm saying, I was a hippie, so he taught me how to give up drugs and get high on God by meditation and yoga. These were Eastern principles of spirituality.
Yeah.
Now, later on, I read this one guru from India. He was named Yogananda. He said, here's how he said it. Basically, spirituality in the West is the Jewish prophets and Jesus. In the East, it's more complex. You have Lord Krishna, Lord Vishnu, Lord Buddha. These incarnations of this kind of God.
Oh, stop.
So that...
Krishna. Where does the word Krishna come from?
It means the all-attractive.
So, well, Krishna comes... That's a bootleg version of Christ.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Similarities are meant to be waking you up.
Well, I mean, because...
When you make your decision of what religion you want to be in.
Because it all comes from the source. Because first you got the spring. Here's the spring. The spring where the fountain came in Israel.
Uh-huh.
And all the little branches went to the other heathen countries.
Okay.
So, because Israel is the source of all knowledge and spirituality.
That makes sense to me. So what about these people that say, I'm not saying I know what you represent. I'm not suspicious of you. It's just a conversation. That they say, okay. So they say all the people of the earth were from one common group of people with Africa.
No, that's not true. Yeah. That's not true.
Those must be Darwinists? What would you say?
Well, no, because that's actually an old teaching that came out when they found the so-called bones of Lucy.
Okay.
Have you ever seen the bones of Lucy?
No, I don't know.
They found like this, a piece of a jawbone, maybe, if you call that a jawbone, I don't know how they can prove that. This big, I mean, it's probably 20% of a skeleton, if that. And they found some pieces of it here, another piece of it 20 miles that way.
Mm-hmm. They try to say they did a DNA testing.
But now that teaching is pretty much laughed at now these days.
Here you go. This is Galatians. This is Galatians 4:26.
Okay.
But Jerusalem, which is above, is free, which is the mother of us all.
Because okay. Jerusalem and Israel.
Spiritually than these. I think these are Darwinists.
Yeah, Darwin.
One seed of man can come from one part of the earth. I don't know where that comes from.
Well, we all do come from Adam.
I understand that.
You know what I mean?
That's spiritual knowledge, too.
The
materialists don't accept all this. You know that, right? They don't accept any of it.
Oh, of course not.
Because here's what I learned by the English guys. This is the age of the religion. Here's what he said. He's not telling people to do this. He said, you can change your religion, but you never change your relationship with God. See where I'm getting
at? Well, because a religion is man-made.
He said the quality of religion is you can be religious, you can practice religion. It's usually only done on one day. It's usually done when you're not using your ego to be
right.
Like, oh, I'm an Indian, I'm an American, I'm a black man, I'm a white man, I'm a woman. You know? So, he's pointing out the divisions in this day and age. See, the Hindu scriptures, the Sanskrit, the scriptures of India, have more scientific knowledge than the Bible. I'm not saying that it's
funny.
Wrong or right. I'm saying
science.
It will not mislead you if you take it for what it is.
Alright.
How many people can read the Bible and not take it for what it is?
Well, most people read the Bible and they don't even know what it says.
It's just a Hall of Fame novel.
Not just anybody can pick up the Bible and read it. This was only given to the elect. A very small percentage of people. This is not for the average zombie out here. This is for the elect, a very small.
Do you ever consider why the majority of people are being misled though?
Yeah, because
the Lord put a spirit in deep sleep on them.
And that's according to the scriptures. The Lord the Lord himself is binding these people.
Like you mentioned division.
Yeah.
The Lord said that he came to bring division.
Okay.
And that's why there is division, because the Lord is He is the great divide. He wants division.
Back
he doesn't.
More,
he,
yeah,
the Lord doesn't
when I was
want unity.
In innocence, approaching Jesus as I was a drug addict, I was suffering. So I said, Jesus, take this burden away from me. And I got into the clearness of what you're doing. And so, like the latest two DVDs I got that are totally spiritually based. There's one called Son of God, the other is called Killing Jesus. And I can compare the two. One is produced by Roma Downey. She's a big Hollywood. She's from Ireland.
What's her name?
She's a chick, Roma Downey.
A woman?
Yeah. Well, she's got a husband, and they're both born again Christians. And they did this.
She's teaching?
She made a movie. No, she made a movie called Son of God based on the New Testament. And it's a powerful movie. You guys don't probably watch
That's all we want.
Nothing
I recommend
buy
that you see that new movie about Jesus.
Right.
Well, mainly the only thing we do watch is documentaries, spiritual teachings, stuff like that. I mean, I'm aware of all this Hindu stuff. I've read the so-called Hindu holy text and all this other madness out there.
Do you see the similarity? Have you ever heard of the Bhagavad Gita?
Yeah.
Do you see the similarity?
Yeah, but
that's the new covenant within all the scriptures in India. It's more powerful.
You know, they try to say they're older than the Bible.
Wow.
But most of those were not written down to paper until around 400 AD.
Let me read this real quick. This is Romans 11 and 7. What then? Israel hath not obtained that which he seeketh for, but the election have obtained it, and the rest were blinded.
The rest were blind. So the elect is a very small number. That's why you see most people walk around in darkness.
According as it is written, the Most High have given them the spirit of slumber.
Spirit of slumber. Yeah.
Eyes that they should not see, and ears that they should not hear until this day.
Right, because how many people out here follow after the spirit? Most people follow after the flesh. They seek after material things, fleshly things.
Mm-hmm.
There's a very small percentage of people who seek spiritual things.
Yeah.
I know you know that.
Yeah, my father was killed when I was 7. I'm so sensitive. Now, to overcome that, when I'm calm enough to meditate, you reach different. See, I meditate, I don't pray.
Meditation is prayer. You know what the word meditate? You know what the word meditate means?
It's the word medicine.
Right, exactly. It comes from to heal. Yeah. Hey, you know something.
Yeah, I'm like on it.
Yeah, we do etymology too. You gotta study the meaning of words.
There's no one for me to talk to. Okay? My neighbors are all white trash alcoholics. In other words, they haven't grown up. So there's self-destruction. All I can have. Here's what I learned about the Eastern religion. This is relating to Jesus too. Love your neighbor as you love yourself. What if your neighbor doesn't love himself? You just wasted your time.
Okay.
So here's what the Dalai Lama said.
I can't hear you.
People that test you, challenge you, test you. Have compassion. That's what when the Dalai Lama was kicked out by the Chinese communist government.
I think he's a con man. Dalai Lama.
I don't know.
I've heard a lot of stories of how they abuse little boys.
Nah.
They rape people. Look into it. Get on the internet.
If you're getting information from the internet, do not trust them.
Everything. Well, the internet is not the internet of 20 years ago. Now everything is on the internet. Now the whole knowledge of the history of the earth is on the internet now.
That's
but there's many documents of witnesses that testify that those Buddhists up there are no different than the Catholic Church. They're raping little boys. They put people in slavery.
I know you don't have time to go into it. The Dalai Lama is an incarnation of early Buddhist teachers. He's not like the other Buddhists. Most Buddhists do not know
I can agree with
why
that.
Lord
a
Buddha came.
You're right about that.
God is a person.
You know reincarnation is in the Bible, right?
It's
a biblical teaching.
You will reincarnate.
What it means, if you see God as a person, you will not reincarnate. You're going to the spiritual world, right? That's how you overcome reincarnation.
If you don't have children,
what did you say?
You become as an angel.
Exactly.
And you become what you were before you were born, a spirit.
Right.
That's what the whole. That's
but when you
I
have children, you come back and you come back to your children.
I don't have any sexual problems. I don't have that desire.
You're past that age.
Well, not only that, I had a choice. One time, what's so important about sex when women are trying to seduce you?
I'm sorry, I can't give you the question.
What's so important about sex when women are trying to seduce you?
Well, I mean, the main thing with sex is to have children.
Well,
and pleasure.
Other
and pleasure.
Than that, if you're not mature enough to take on that responsibility, why would you do that?
That's true, that's right.
There's a certain amount of innocence in everyone.
That's why when you have sex with a woman, see, people don't take sex serious out here. Sex is a serious deal. When you lay down with a woman, you ain't supposed to ever leave her. She's supposed to stay with you forever. When you lay with a woman, you and her spirit become as one.
Okay.
Okay? Because that sperm has spirits. Each sperm cell is alive and it has a spirit in it. Yeah. And when you put your sperm inside of a woman, your spirit is going into her.
That's
and then your
sense.
Spirit and her spirit become as one.
Her actual
planned.
Body is
right.
transformed
yeah.
to suit you.
Yeah, your sperm okay. transforms.
See, here's what I'm suspicious about. You base everything on one book.
No, that's because of the
Buddhists. Yeah, the Buddhists believe you give up sex, that spiritual power in you is more powerful than that desire, so you can be celibate. The Dalai Lama.
Well,
the Lord said,
a Buddhist that we do
let me tell you something. The Lord said to be fruitful and multiply.
What about the people that
children are a gift.
Aren't into that.
Not only that, because we're going to colonize the universe. Okay, and you can't do that unless you're having sex.
That's right.
Okay, see, the Bible's a manly book. We like women.
Yeah.
We like drinking. We like talking shit.
You like drinking, too?
Yeah, the Lord
like to drink.
The Lord drink wine.
I understand. We're not alcoholics.
Did he get drunk?
Well, you can't drink without getting drunk.
You get a buzz.
You get a buzz.
I don't think
no, we're not
saying. People walking around.
Like, I don't drink that often. So when I like to drink. The Lord, in the Last Supper, all the disciples drank wine.
Right.
The Lord said that the wine was his blood.
Well, scientifically, here's what we're missing. Scientifically, there was not enough clean water. How do you store the stuff to drink? Nutrition.
They had clean water back. They had springs.
Did they have enough? Why did they need wine?
Well, the population wasn't as bad.
It's just a manly thing. Drink wine.
What about women?
Which are in the presence of her husband at home.
Well,
okay.
For me personally, I don't want my women drinking.
Neither
I don't want them smoking or doing nothing.
In those days. But
in those days.
My choice of thing was marijuana.
Wait, to make something kosher, all I have to do is pray on this kosher.
Well,
I pray the Lord to bless.
Why would Jesus need wine when there's clean water?
Okay, let me tell you. Okay, you go to the hood.
Like to drink.
This is just a small example. Go to the hood,
right.
Like the bad parts of the hood,
yeah.
and talk to them fools like, brother, be good, be brotherly to one another. And do it day after day after day.
Yeah.
Be brotherly to one another. Love, you know. Do that and see if you don't want to take a drink of wine.
It helps relieve stress.
After 2-3 months,
yeah.
Just go to the hood. Just talk to these people.
Well, there's a difference between being drunk and trying to take the edge off.
If you're mature enough to handle alcohol.
So why did the Lord create the vine?
The vine.
Well, wine comes from the word vine. Yeah. Why did the Lord
talk about the organic principles of that?
It is organic.
What about the things that aren't organic?
Oh, here,
it's turned into alcohol.
For example, like what?
When Noah, let me get the scripture. When Noah got off the ark, he was very stressed.
Right.
The first thing that Noah did when he got off that ark, he planted a vineyard, and he got drunk.
I just got that DVD, Noah, played by Russell Crowe. I didn't see that film.
Oh, I still haven't watched it.
That's a
terrible
movie.
It's a terrible movie. What I'm saying, what choice do you have? Do I want to get on cable TV and watch superficial nonsense? Do I want to watch Trump every night?
It's all the same shit.
We watch that too. Okay. Anytime there's a Bible movie come out, regardless of how many discrepancies are in it, we're going to watch it.
There's something there that you can learn. It reminds you of what you already know.
Just like that Exodus movie that just came out with Christian Bale. Exodus of, what was that, Gods and Men?
I've seen that too. It's not too good.
Sorry, it's obviously not word for word in the Bible, but
right.
I mean, there's still good points in it.
My favorite original movie was The Last Temptation of Christ.
I'm sure I have. I've seen
Mark
so many of them.
Really?
Oh, the one, William Dafoe?
Yes.
That's the one where he didn't die. So that's,
no, it was he went into a dream and said, "I'm gonna marry and have children, and I don't have to be Christian. I don't have to."
That movie was blasphemy.
No, it was, because all the guys that were doing it, they weren't real Christians. They're show business. Show business ego. Stressed out movie stars, but they tried. You understand? The Baptist Church, the Protestants, broke that. No, Martin Scorsese was raised in the worst part of Little Italy. He wanted to be a priest, he got asked, he couldn't do it. He wanted to be a gangster, he got asked, he couldn't do it. So he became a movie director. See, he still has some spiritual, some innocence there, even though he's making all these nonsense movies. He's a rich movie director. He still has enough innocence to represent something.
Now he's responsible for millions of people wanting to be gangsters.
Well, have you ever lived around here? I lived in New York City for years.
I grew up with gangsters. I was related to gangsters.
Have you seen someone actual shot gangsters in front of you?
I've seen people blown heads blown off in front of
there
me.
There you go.
Heads
I've seen that
off
too.
Heads blown off. I've seen people chopped up.
Yeah.
You know, damn near cut it, chopped up in pieces. They, you know, I've seen the worst of violence in front in my presence. So I grew up with scum of the earth. You know, scum of the earth. People that, you know, no matter what kind of changing and I'm a new Christian, these people ain't gonna get delivered.
No.
You know.
See, here's the point of me bringing that up. I was still innocent enough. I was a stupid hippie. When I was using drugs, it was marijuana, LSD. These guys were selling heroin, cocaine, narcotics. They were using guns. They were using women to get them into that. And then using the women for what? Hippies never did that. We believed in the age of Aquarius. You understand that? No, this is
oh, we know about the age of Aquarius.
Okay, that's why I never got into alcohol. In high school, all my friends that drank, they're too tough. I don't like the women. I don't like the cars. I don't like them making fun of me. I like them calling me gay. I've never, a few times I've had sex with women with nothing more than experimentation.
Yeah.
No. Have you ever surfed? That's when I first, before I learned about yoga, I'm doing surf.
Never
surf. Use all the energy of your kundalini body to surf. It's
kundalini
sex.
Again, your kundalini, do you charge up your chakras?
I've done that before.
I was just messing with you.
No, well, the opposite of that is to be calm enough to receive the Lord. You've got different desires going on when you meditate. What do you say? When you pray, you have to... What about Satan? What do they pray to?
Satan.
Why would they get so desire and passionate about that?
Well, the satanic teaching is to be carnal. And they believe the same thing as pretty much the Darwinist philosophy. Survival of the fittest. Survival of the fittest is what Satanists believe in. They believe the weak should, the strong should rule the weak.
That's no better than Constantine and all the worldly churches.
That's right.
How many of the popes even tried to understand the real Jesus? Think about that.
But
absolutely
Catholic
none.
Church is bullshit, pretty much.
Wouldn't you say that's the worldly church?
Of course.
If you go back to the roots, didn't St. Peter go to Rome?
Well, not Peter. Peter was a man that... Here, I got a scripture for you.
Okay.
Let me read this.
See, I get confused about how religion came to
the Catholic Church. The Catholic Church was set up by our people, but then it was hijacked. And then over the years, they destroyed it. The Catholic Church today does not teach the original doctrine that was taught by the apostles. Because the Catholic Church, they teach paganism.
I agree.
They celebrate Christmas, which is paganism. They celebrate Easter, which is the worshiping of Ishtar, the goddess of fertility. So everything they do is based upon paganism. They don't follow the Bible.
Do you think the Eastern Orthodox Church is closer to...
It might be a little better, but it's still not right.
So you can
see... Because the Eastern Orthodox Church is a continuation of the Byzantine Church.
Okay.
For going back to Constantine.
That's what I say. I'm an intellectual.
Both the Western Church and the Eastern Church, they both come from the church set up by Constantine and Theodosius, going back to the Byzantine Empire. It all goes from the same root.
You think there's some scriptures that were thrown out by that council that would help people today?
There was no scriptures thrown out, though. It was never a scripture. So this should be thrown out. People like to do that. That's something a good snake oil salesman would do. Well, during the Council of Nicaea, they banned the Book of Enoch. They banned the Book of Mary. They banned the Gospel of Judas. Or the Gospel, what's the other one? The Gospel of Barnabas.
You ever heard of the Gospel?
Huh? We've heard of them. Well,
okay.
Well, St. Thomas is more legitimate than some of the other ones.
But. Right.
St. Thomas says the same thing as Matthew.
Oh, yeah.
There you go.
It says,
well,
that's
kind of a good Jew and a good Christian. No. Matthew was the closest to Jesus. Another Jew, which is the one translated. Jesus, the original word, better than the other.
Y'all Jews?
Admit that. So, what I'm saying is, I think Peter and Paul did not do Jesus that sort of
thing.
James was trying to keep the church circumcision and kosher diet.
Let me read something for you. This is Matthew 16 and 17.
Okay.
And Jesus answered and said unto him, blessed art thou, Simon Bar-Jonah, which is Peter.
Okay.
For flesh and blood have not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. And I say also unto thee, thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church. That's this church, about? Not the Catholic Church.
Okay.
I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail
Jesus
against
ain't
me.
A nigga.
So not, no matter what Peter did, it was nothing will stop. Nothing
he said nigga?
The nigga too.
Peter never
said that.
Went left, took a left turn. He was going down the straight gate the whole time. Peter,
that's crazy.
Peter never strayed from the straight gate, from that straight path. So anybody teaching that Peter perverted the gospel, they're perverting the gospel.
No, I don't think that. What I'm saying is a lot of people say
the Catholic Church, they try to, they use this scripture right here to attempt to give themselves legitimacy. They're like, well, this church was started by Peter.
Okay.
So that's how they try to bring legitimacy to their church. They'll use this exact scripture to say that this is why you should follow us, because Peter was the first pope. But what they fail to tell you, the Catholic Church was perverted a long time ago. And the original teachings of the church are nowhere to be found in the Catholic Church of today. Nowhere to be found in there.
Here's my biggest problem with the Pope. He's got to shave every day. What the hell is that about?
Right. The Bible
That's
says
against the law.
It's against the law to shave your beard.
I understand it. I understand it now.
Yeah.
When I was growing up, I didn't understand it.
So that tells you that the Catholic Church is not following what Peter taught. I guarantee you Peter had a beard.
I understand.
You know what I'm saying?
My father was Jewish.
And another thing, too. The Catholic priests, they're not allowed to have sex.
Yeah.
And
they don't even have the choice.
Peter had a wife. Peter had a wife.
No, I understand. I have no problem with that. Here's the problem I have.
Your church can't even grow if you don't have children.
Huh?
Oh, go, no.
How are we supposed to build a nation if no one's having children?
No, I understand. I'm like getting to my
I don't have enough knowledge to take on the Catholic Church.
Common people wanted to read the Bible on their own. They didn't want the king saying, oh, I will read the Bible, I will tell you what to be.
Well, by that, yeah, well, it's kind of common. Yeah.
When they 50 deep.
Yeah, the Protestant movement started because they wanted to have the Bible.
They still skirt.
And first started with the Germans and Martin Luther, and later it spread to England. And, right, because,
so, you know.
But, you know, that's a good point you made. Why did the Catholic Church not want the Bible translated to the common tongue? Because then it would expose all their lies.
They wanted to hold the power.
Because if the people found out what the Bible actually said, then the jig is up for the Catholic Church. It's up for them.
Well, the point of that is that eventually, by the time, was Martin Luther the first one to say the Catholic Church was this bad?
Man, there's been disputes going all the way back way back to, you know, the 3rd century, going way back. You ever hear of Aryans?
Yeah.
You had Arianism.
You know where the word comes from? It comes from Sanskrit.
Well, no, it's a different Aryan. It's a Gothic speaking people who wrote
that. Oh, you're talking about by the color of their skin?
No. Aryan, they're Gothics. You know, they like Scandinavian type people. They come from Gotham.
You know, people that don't believe God think race is better than the black race based on that stupid stuff you're saying? Yep. I'm not saying.
Well, no,
you know better.
That's a different type of Aryan. Okay. That's a totally different word.
Okay.
But the Aryans were that's where the word Iran comes from. But this is a different Aryan. These were Gothic people.
Okay.
They weren't white supremacists. They probably had dark skin, actually.
Okay.
They were probably black skin. But listen, they didn't believe in the Trinity.
Right.
The God, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Because the Bible doesn't ever mention something called the Trinity. Because they actually had the Bible written in their own tongue. And they believe what the Bible actually said. And they didn't believe in the state religion. They believed in the Bible. So they were hunted, they were persecuted.
Okay. Yeah, I know a Quaker. He tuned me into it. Like, their meditation, their prayer is just so simple. They refuse to have program preachers. You know anything about Quakers?
I know Benjamin Franklin.
It came from the Glorious Revolution.
Right.
And they believe that the worldly church is trying to keep people that are based on the Bible, trying to find God within themselves. Trying to be what maybe Jesus was here, but those people that knew who Jesus was, they wouldn't have to work. They wouldn't go back to the Bible. Is that Jesus? No, they know. Okay. So they go. They were the first people demonstrating against slavery, first people to not participate in nation states wars.
Yeah.
That all came from the Glorious Revolution in England with the kings and queens. I don't care if you're Catholic or Protestant. Go to war when the king or me, the queen, who's ever talking, says so. What's that got to do with Jesus?
Well, you got a lot to do with him. He said, I come not to bring peace on earth, I came to bring the sword. The Lord's the one who calls all these wars. The Lord came to bring division. And he's laughing the whole time. He likes the war. He likes the division. He likes the fight. The Lord
so
said,
you're doing this the way people are.
Right, this is all information.
It's just for a few. This ain't for everybody.
Right. I mean, because the Bible says that we're not ignorant of the wiles of the devil. Like, this right here, the government false flag attacks. That's part of the wiles of the devil. Implanting microchips in human beings so they can track us and trace us. That's part of the wiles of the devil.
I've been hearing that a long time.
That's the Lord's plan. Why, that's the Lord.
That's still going on.
Well, now we're at that stage where the technology is at the point where it's possible.
Here's what the Buddhists and the Hindus believe. I'm not saying that they have anything better new, or they're completely as bad as some of these people out here. They believe this is the age of irreligion. Now, that's missing to a lot of Christians and Jews and Muslims. They believe that instead of just one deity, like being Satan or the Antichrist, it's more complex than that. The longer we get away from when Jesus was here on earth and we're not knowing ourselves, testing the word, testing the flesh, testing, if our government says to go to a false war, can we do that? No, that's what the Quakers taught me. So, let's say, this is also the age of impersonalism. Most religions the Christians are not seeking the true Christ. That's just the generalist mistake.
Of course not.
I've been doing that all my life. The majority of Hindus do not seek the source of Hinduism. And Hinduism means the Persians, the Iranians, Indo-European, they're not Semitic people. They don't belong to be Muslims, they got conquered. How long
Most of them are Elamites. They descend from Elam.
You know a little bit about this. So, here's what's so bad about this. The worldly government is dividing these people according to the age of religion for so long, people are lost in that. You understand? Why does Israel represent what it represents? Because Jesus lived in... What was the two kingdoms when he was here?
Of course, you had the northern and southern kingdom.
There you go.
That's where we're here to wake up. Look. We're here to wake up the lost sheep at the house of Israel. There's more Israelites on this planet than any other people. And they're scattered among all these heathen nations. Look, the Hindus are heathens. The Buddhists are heathens. All these other nations are all heathens. But our people are scattered among them. So
Here's what I learned about Israel right today. The majority of people do not have enough money to get proper housing.
Who, Palestinians?
No, Jewish people, and citizens of Israel.
And Israel.
It might be because all the biggest Muslims coming in.
That's the biggest welfare state on the planet Earth.
There you go.
Yeah, they're living good over there.
Yeah, they live good over there.
Yeah.
What I'm saying
on our tax dollars.
Okay, the majority of Palestinians live in Jordan, right?
That's Palestinians, though.
Yeah.
Yeah. I had a social worker. She's a Palestinian. I was so bad, my neighbors attacking and stuff. I had to go to her to get food stamps and stuff, get Medicaid and stuff. She was innocent enough to help me, where all these other people have been worn out by the neighborhood you're talking about.
Right.
They won't deal with me. They don't have time because I don't have a cell phone and a computer.
Right.
So what am I getting at? Did I ask her, are you a Muslim? Do you hate Jews? I said, I'm Jewish. My father was Jewish and I'm killed. So right there she knew I needed help. She took the time to help me. I no longer matter. It's called impersonalization. Whether she's a Muslim, Palestinian, she might be a Palestinian Christian. She never told me.
Yeah.
She was proud to be a Palestinian. My lawyer, who I worked for a long time, his name is Abraham, and he's from Lebanon. I don't know if he's Jewish, or Muslim, or Christian, or Lebanese. See, I've been through that in my personal life.
Yeah.
Okay? So I'm dependent on
social. So we don't judge people by their appearance.
I can understand that.
We judge people by their spirit.
Yeah.
Our people, the Israelites, are scattered. Because we're the descendants of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Physically.
Sense.
Physically and spiritually.
Yeah. So you understand. Here's my point. When I met this girl from India, I gave up hallucinogenic drugs.
Are you sure they did?
No, in India.
Really?
In India, they're so religious there, at the same time, they're religious. A lot of Shiva, they smoke ganja.
Yeah.
They go into trances. They won't cut their hair. They won't bathe. They won't trim their hair.
That's
they walk around naked.
Hey, if anyone they eat a bowl of soup with the rats,
they don't care. When they're high on ganja or hashish, they don't care. They can no longer discriminate. I'm a vehicle of God, okay? That's the age of irreligion.
They're allowed to do that. Laws of cleanliness and all that.
Yeah.
You know.
So what I'm saying is the high class Hindus, which are considered twice born, you ever heard about some of this?
Oh yeah, they have class systems. And
it's called the caste
system. Oh, excuse me. It's the wrong word. Caste system.
Too many people have been discriminated for so long that they wouldn't let the Muslims come in and tell them how to be religious. They wouldn't let the British come in and tell them how to be religious. So they had to make up their religion organically in India. You know what the word India means?
It comes from the word Hindu.
No, the word India predates Hinduism. It means inside of you is a deity.
The word India and Hindu is the same word.
That's Persians named the people on the other side of the Indus River.
The Indus Valley.
Hindu. It's just a word. The majority of Indians don't think of themselves as Hindus.
Well, you got a lot of different, but they're all, for the most part, they're Elamites. They descend from Elam.
It doesn't matter to me.
Well, I mean, because the Bible has the table of nations.
Okay.
It tells you where all the peoples of the earth descend from.
What
they descend from a man named Elam. The Arabs descend from a man named Ishmael.
Here's a concept that'll open you up. I'm not preaching.
Right.
You ever heard there's two classes of people today? Semitic people. And you could call them Gentiles, they're also called Aryans. Aryan is a word in the Sanskrit scriptures in India that means the noble ones.
Right.
Before the Aryans settled in northern India, they were wandering around Asia. The Rus, they're Aryans.
The
non-Semitic, you ever heard of Russia? Rus
comes from Rus. Those are Viking people.
Right, they were pagans.
Right, but hold on a second, the Vikings were Israelite. But the word Semitic comes from the Hebrew word Shem,
right,
which Noah had three sons, Ham, Shem, and Japheth. So there are more people than just Shemites. The word Aryan is not even in the Bible.
That's because it comes from the Hindu scriptures.
Well, but the Hindus were the Elam. So
never heard
the Elamites are Shemitic people.
Okay.
They come out of Shem.
Okay.
Like the Egyptians, the ancient Egyptians, they're not Shemitic.
Yeah.
They're Hamitic. They come from Ham.
So all your knowledge is based on that.
Well,
those scriptures.
We have genealogies.
Okay. What about the people? You ever heard this? This might be total speculation, and I think it's true. You ever heard about this? Two major groups of people.
There's three.
According to Lang. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. The Buddhists and the Hindus read their scriptures. You ever heard of Sanskrit?
Yeah, Sanskrit.
It's the mother tongue of all the Indo-European languages.
Well, Indo-European language is a theoretic language.
Okay.
A Proto-Indo-European. No. It doesn't exist.
Okay, you mentioned.
There's no such thing as Indo-European.
Okay.
It doesn't exist.
Okay. Have you ever heard the reason a lot of people, before the Bible was translated, before it was written down, how did they know the word?
The word. We got around the word.
Okay. The same thing the Hindus and the Buddhists believe. They use sound vibrations through those languages before it was written down, and they heard it, they remembered it, and they meditated. Later, when the age of religion really kicked in, God had to come back to earth. That's all they had, the scriptures. They had a few holy people walk around the new secrets of the spiritual world.
But the Hindus, especially what I'm trying to tell you, is that Hindus are heathens.
Yeah.
And everything they're teaching is a lie.
Yeah, okay. And just because something seems ancient, it don't mean it's right.
They sacrificed children in the ancient world too.
And, that's right.
And then they meditated after they did
that's
it.
That's right, yeah.
And they meditated like,
That's right.
I mean, so.
Well, what you're talking about.
You know, the Hinduism sounds good, especially a lot of these New Age philosophies. Like you said, you're the hippie. Yeah. So, and a big part of this New Age
philosophy. No, we're Israelites.
Okay.
In the Bible.
We're Israelites,
you,
right.
Just 5 months ago.
Huh?
I saw
Israel.
He's all black.
The Israelites.
Star David. Asked, what do you represent?
We're the Jews.
I just looked at him and go, no, you're not the Jews.
He's ready to come these people.
Have you talked to them?
Oh,
people?
He did.
Yeah.
What?
He said, were they wearing
said,
white?
Were the Jews?
Were they wearing white and red?
Pure white, yeah. Red. A Star David here.
Yeah.
Turbans and all this nonsense.
Yeah. Yeah.
So what? I don't know. They look like they're too confused to even talk to.
But they are Jews, but they're full of shit.
They say you use Esau.
Man, no, I didn't even tell them who I was. I knew they were
evil people. You're right. They are evil people.
Okay.
He got that vibration. He picked that up.
They're definitely evil. There's no doubt about that.
Right. Because they're all about making money.
Yeah.
Bringing more people in just so they can pay tithes.
Based on racism?
They're racism, too. They're racist.
Based on more physical appearance.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to say race.
Right.
Because race is a Hebrew. We're racist. I'm a racist.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. The word race is a Hebrew word, ra'ash, which means the head. Who's the head? There's only one head.
Yeah.
And that's the Lord.
Right.
And the Lord has a chosen people.
Right.
He has a chosen race, a head people.
Okay.
Israel.
So how would these people be saying we're the Jews?
Well, like I said, these people are set up.
Well, we are. Well, not like that, but we are telling people we're Israelite. I told you multiple times already that we're Israelite. We're the seed of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. I've said that numerous times.
So, in other words, they're representing who?
Just Negroes.
Have you ever talked to them?
Just Negroes.
Yeah, we've
strict races. You're misleading people.
They don't understand.
Right, exactly.
They don't understand. That our people are scattered among other nations.
Now listen,
I've heard that.
If you grew up nothing around black people, right? You grew up around nothing but blacks, right? And you got a black woman.
That woman in the Bahamas.
Okay, imagine you 15, 16.
They weren't even my people.
Listen, bro.
Yeah.
And you 20 years old. You.
Yeah.
You want to make a family, you want to have children. The only people worshiping around is that black woman, right? You have a child with that black woman. That child's going to come out with some color, right? They ain't going to come out, it might come out looking like you. It might come out looking like you, but that child is still around black folks, right? And get to another black child and have a baby. That race is going to get darker. It's going to get darker, okay? I'm just explaining to you that our people, the Lord scattered our people amongst all the nations of the earth.
Those people wouldn't have time enough to tell me, and I could get
because they don't know.
They don't know.
They don't know themselves.
They judge
that
people. They judge by the flesh.
How can you be that?
They're not spiritual at all. They're fleshly. They're carnal.
But
Well, here's one way I overcame.
I explained it backwards. It's like
one way. Like he's just saying, if a black dude was in the Marines, went to Vietnam, got himself a Vietnamese hooker, and he had sex with that woman.
I don't need to hear this.
Well, I'm just saying,
just listen,
but listen. He had a baby. But that baby's going to look kind of dark, but it's going to look Vietnamese.
But he went back to America.
He went back to America.
The war is over, but his child is still over
there. He don't even know he had a child.
Here's how I overcame racism.
But listen, that baby keeps having sex with Vietnamese people.
I don't want to talk.
But listen, what's the descendants going to look like? Are they all going to look black? 100 years later, his descendants are all going to look Vietnamese.
Here's how I overcame racism. When Martin Luther King, who I figured the white trash racist, never calm enough to even listen to him, much less see who he is, the Baptist preacher.
Right.
Okay. So, later on, I'm tuning into Bob Marley, who believes there's a word called Jah. You know.
It means Jah.
Okay.
It's God, Yahweh.
It's a sound vibration. There's nothing wrong with that, is there?
It's short for Yahweh, which is God's name in Hebrew.
His father was white, his mother was black. So, how would he represent?
You say Bob Marley?
Yeah.
Right, his dad was white, right?
Right.
His dad
was English. He was a Jake, though.
Yeah, because
he was English.
That's a perfect example.
Mm-hmm. There you go.
And black people love Bob. And most black, that's a good point, because most black people will love Bob Marley. Well, a lot of them will love Bob Marley, but hate white people.
Right.
And they don't even know his dad was
white. But have you noticed a lot of white people love Bob Marley?
Yep, they love him.
I used to.
Because that's what Jake said.
Because
those are Jakes.
Those are Israelites. Those white people are Israelites.
That's what I was getting to. When I was just the passion of the music and his protest.
Spiritual music.
Yeah. Remember when you and first walked up the first few minutes, I said, you got a spirit of like one of us? Yeah. Remember I said that?
Yeah.
Now you know where we're going with this.
Bob Marley was tuning into, he was talking about the Israelites who were in Babylon, symbolically representing part of the tribes of Israel as
he
being
went
dispersed.
Off He was on that Haile Selassie bullshit too. But he was spiritual.
That's a form of naturalism.
But he was spiritual though. Right, yeah.
Which could lead to racism. Which could lead to sexism. You see, isms are not, you know.
The hell with the isms.
Who was that dude that made the song? The Israelites.
Desmond Decker. You heard that reggae song? The Israelites.
I was into reggae for a while.
You don't see
so
the Israelis.
I love reggae.
You don't see the Israelis making up hits like that.
No.
Where they Israel, Israeli lights.
They sing the Hashem.
right.
I got one DVD. It's about
heathens.
Israel. It's a nice documentary sponsored by
Grove Heathen.
And the best rabbis.
Edomites.
Who are holding the book and keeping their people. There's like cooking organic food. Handing it out to him. You're one of us.
You know what the word rabbi means?
Teacher.
In Hebrew, it means great.
Great.
No, it just means great. No, when you look at the word rab in Hebrew means great.
So when they first called Jesus rabbi,
what did he say? Hey, let's get that scripture. He said, why you call me rabbi? There was only one that is great, and that's the Father which is in heaven. He said, call no man rabbi. Because there is only one that is great, and that's the Father that which is in heaven.
So you got humble enough to wake them up.
Rabbi,
you're going to see who I really am, you know who I really am.
A rabbi, that's one of those flattering titles, a vain title.
Okay.
You know, it's a title of vanity. Okay. The one takes upon themselves, I'm a great teacher.
Well, the only other DVD, I have this book called A Stranger Amongst Us.
Yeah.
It's directed by Sidney Lumet, who's a New York City director. It's about Melanie Griffith, a cop, who has to solve this murder in a Hasidic community of New York City. Manhattan, they're diamond merchants.
Yeah.
And eventually, she has to live among Hasidic Jews to feel comfortable enough to solve this murder. All the while, she wants to seduce this rabbi, who's teaching her about the Kabbalah.
The Kabbalah.
Yeah, he's talking about the secret powers of sex through this world.
Yeah, witchcraft.
Well, the whole point of the movie, that's a secular movie, but it's pointing out that Sidney Lumet in real life was a Jew. He became a big city director. He made gangsters. He made Dog Day Afternoon. He made Surfer Gun.
Okay, I've seen Surfer Gun.
Al Pacino's best movie. Jew and an Italian who live in Manhattan all the time. They don't have calm enough time to become a hippie or Israelite. They don't have time enough to understand all you are is a vehicle for God to respond to the next person you meet. If you want to isolate yourself, maybe that's God's time to protect yourself. All I'm getting at, I'm glad I met you. I gotta go back to my white trash drunk neighbors and figure out how to get to the weekend with my Lambo and get all these help.
It was interesting talking to you, man.
Yeah. I gotta catch the bus and then, you know, I just wanted to know that I didn't want to see another group of, we're the Jews. And no, this is just.
We are the Jews.
Okay, you're the Israelites too.
Right.
You're simultaneously one and different to God.
Well, all the Jew is short word.
Judah.
That's all it is.
There's 12 tribes. There's more than just Jews.
Right. There's 12 tribes.
So is the kingdom of Judah when Jesus was alive?
The northern tribes.
But the Lord's going to bring the southern and northern kingdom back together. And we're going to be one.
Okay.
You know, that's the kingdom of heaven. But first, this kingdom right here has got to be turned to a pile of ashes. The Lord's bringing fire on this earth. And he's going to destroy everything that you see.
A pile of ashes.
A pile of ashes.
Literally, we're saying.
Let me give you one more scripture to leave you.
And this is scriptural. We ain't just ain't nothing talking about hearts.
No, I'm not.
You know.
I'm not like that.
Let me send you
this
one.
This place has to go, because this place, this horror that caused hell on the whole planet Earth. You know, and it's behind all the shit that's going on the planet Earth. This place in his mind thinks that only way we're going to save ourselves is we got to destroy those other nations. And that's what's going on now. World War III is coming quick.
That passion, okay?
Right.
Be hoodwinked to what you're talking about.
Right.
Like, I know right now, John Kerry spent all this time making this nuclear Iran deal. And if the Ayatollah wants to get the nuclear bomb, they're going to do it no matter what.
They already got it. They already got it.
That's all theatrics. That's all behind closed doors. That's all theatrics.
Mm-hmm.
You know, John Kerry, he's part of the so-called Illuminati.
You think so?
We know so. That's why he's here. Why you see him on the television all day long?
Well, let me send you on your way with this. Malachi 4:1. For behold, the day cometh. Behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven.
God damn.
And all the proud, yea, all that do wickedly shall be stubborn.
Judgment day.
And the day that cometh shall burn them up, saith the Lord of hosts, that it shall leave them neither root nor branch. So that's what's coming. Let me keep going. But unto you that fear my name, Yahweh Basham, Yahweh Shah, shall the Son of Righteousness arise with healing in his wings, and ye shall go forth and grow up as calves in the stall, and ye shall tread down the wicked.
Tread down.
That's talking about us. And ye shall